Whenever I do that at home, my kids go, "Dad, just stop right there. You're going to execute that. It's not going to be pretty." After those stories I just heard, I think I just need to pass the hat, take an offering, and we need to call it a day, right? That was pretty impressive stuff. But you get me for the next little bit of time, and I'm going to share some stuff with you about how we transition these ideas into actually turning it into a business. There is something that we all do, and this is not a hobby. This is actually the business that we're involved in. So I'm in the successful doctor business. That's what I do. I'm in practice just like you are. I'm in my office at 6:30 every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. And I am seeing patients by 6:15 because we open at 6:30, but people show up at 6 o'clock. They're crazy. And they actually have their checks already filled out because they're excited they're going to get in before the line gets long. Now, if I made them schedule an appointment at 6 o'clock in the morning, they'd hate me. But instead, they think it's a great idea because they're there ahead of time. But you know what's interesting is, because I'm in practice, my practice is a petri dish. It's an opportunity for me to try every idea, every concept, because I'm just like you. I come to events like this all over the world because I get a chance to teach all over the world. But when I get to hear other people, I am interested because if I get one thing out of everything that somebody says, I can turn that into more business in my office. So today I want to share some ideas with you. Now, guess what? Some of these ideas are going to be things you've never heard before. Some of them are going to be things that you're like, "Well, gee, I thought of that 30 years ago." And so some are going to be new, some are not. But I just want us to get started with a simple thing. Now, what's tomorrow? It's Halloween, right? So I might as well start with a Halloween joke, don't you think? How much does it cost a pirate to get their ears pierced? It's a buccaneer. Okay, so now you can tell that to everybody. You can even tell it to your kids, and nobody's going to be offended, right? So here we go. How many of you got ICD-10 going in your offices, right? Since October 1st, how many of us are experiencing that? Because I am. Are you using any of these codes yet? They should be pretty much every day. Because since ICD-10 started, I think these are pretty frequent. Number one, we've got irritable bowel with diarrhea. This, of course, is for the doctor and staff, right? Number two is diarrhea unspecified. I've got a little bit of that going on at my office. Number three is outlet dysfunction constipation. Some of that's going on as well. And number four is gastrointestinal mucositis, ulcerative. Can you believe the stuff we have to go through in our offices to keep these people happy? Is it changing one thing that you're doing when you adjust your patient so far? I don't think so. I think your adjustment is still the same, but yet we have all this exciting new stuff that we get to add in, and guess what? It's just the price of admission. That's all it is. And the whole world hasn't come crashing down either, has it? Somehow we've all survived. Somehow we've gone to some little seminar. We've learned what the conversion factors are. We've figured out how to make that work. So we like to poke fun at it a little bit, but it's okay. We're going to survive. They're not going to be able to throw anything at us that's going to be too hard of a curveball for us to hit because, you know what? We're chiropractors. Right? We can figure it out. So I'm going to use this little dollar figure up here because at the end of your day, I want your hobby, I want the thing that you're doing to be fun, but I need you to be able to make a living with it. Because if we're going to continue to change the world, we're going to have some financial ability to be able to make that happen. Because as good as you are, I teach technique, and I have people sitting in the front row that are amazing technicians, but sometimes they have empty offices, and they're starving, just like the stories you heard. But if we can figure out how to turn that thing around, and we can suddenly remedy it, it just means we get to help more people. So if we're going to take a look at this, I want you to learn about the three biggest lies that are being told to us out there, because we're in 2015, and it's time for us to move forward. So number one, one of the biggest lies that we run into, this is a guy who talks lies, right, because we hear it all the time, is number one, use our stuff. And if you do, you'll have unlimited new patients. It's all about the stuff. I have a confession to make. I sell stuff, but guess what? Stuff doesn't work. How many of you have a hammer at home? Anybody? More of you can, it's okay if you raise your hands, really, it's okay, all right? I'm not going to pick on you too much. I will in a little bit, but not too much. What do you think that hammer's doing right now? Do you think it's out in the garage and it's talking to some nails saying, hey, she's gone right now. Let's get together and go hang out with our buddy the wood over there and let's whack some into the wood. Do you think that's going on? No, that tool is sitting in the toolbox doing absolutely nothing. It doesn't work by itself. So when we talk about stuff, what you have to understand is, I don't care whose stuff you're working with or looking at, if it's sitting in your closet, how many chiropractors do we have in here right now? How many of you have a stuff closet at your office? If your staff was here, they'd say, right here. You have a closet full of things you've been to seminars and you've bought because while you were there, it made some kind of an emotional appeal to you, and you're like, wow, that would change my practice. You buy a whole bunch of it, then you get it back to your office, and your staff goes, not going to happen. That just looks like more work for me, and I'm not going to do it, and it gets put into the stuff closet. Students, raise your hands. Doctors, if you have a stuff closet, raise your hands. Go ahead, come on, get them up. Students, go talk to these doctors and say, can I just have this stuff in your closet? Because it will clean that closet out, and students might actually put it to work. Because you're sitting there hiding it and hoarding it in your closet like a hoarder, and yet it's not doing any good where it is. So give it to some of these students who actually need it, because they are starving. They're poor. They're eating ramen noodles. 5 days a week, they're eating ramen noodles. I watched Shark Tank last night. Some guy invented this new little dish that cooks ramen noodles perfectly, and the sharks gave him $300,000 for it to launch it, so you'll be able to buy it anywhere you want. Look for it in the stores, it's coming, $4.50. And it makes them taste just like you boiled them instead of microwaved them. Isn't that an amazing fact to get at a Parker seminar? Should you ever eat that stuff? Absolutely not. But as a student, we've all been there, done that, and got the t-shirt, right? So when I'm talking about using stuff, I want you to understand right now, my stuff doesn't work any better than anybody else's. This is 100% about your personality, your willingness, and your ability to put stuff to work. Your car's sitting out there doing nothing right now other than it's costing you money, even while it's sitting still. Stuff is the same way. You either decide to put it to work or you don't. So we can relax because I'm not up here selling anything. I'm just going to share ideas that you can decide you either like or you don't like, and then you get to decide what you want to put to work from an idea standpoint. All right? So, thinking about that, stuff doesn't work. Tools need somebody to turn them on and use them, and our environment is changing every day. Every Monday morning when I get to my office, I have to reinvent something about my practice. I've been in practice for 33 years now. And every single Monday morning, I have to do something new. I have to fix something, I have to repair something, I have to change something, because rules change consistently. And you know what? That's kind of what makes it exciting. Because we all wonder, is our staff going to show up today? Especially if you're married to your staff or you're dating your staff, you really wonder, well, she was a little mad when I left this morning, I hope she shows up. So there's some old ideas and there's some new ideas. One of the tools and one of the concepts that we talked about in advertising this class was, some of this stuff isn't really getting new patients in the door anymore. So let's take a look at some of these old ideas and let's see what they are. Number one, we have the free chicken dinner idea. Now back in the 70s and the early 80s, this was a huge marketing tool. It was free chicken dinners for anybody who would come to your lay lecture and you'd get a chance to get them in, right? Then we had Yellow Pages. How many of us used to fight and buy the very first full page ad in the Yellow Pages, and it was thousands of dollars a month? When was the last time you even opened a phone book? Because all of you have a smartphone and you just with your thumb and you do it like that and you find it now on a search. You don't use that anymore, but yet somehow we still have to pay for it, because if we don't pay for our Yellow Page ad, you can't find us in the search engines either, right? They somehow link it to us, so they're still getting us. Newspaper ads. There's a few of them that might still work, but guess what? How many of you read a newspaper this morning? Want to raise your hands? Anybody want to look around at all? Two of you. And you're so ancient and old that, no. Right? My dad still reads a newspaper. He's 85. I haven't seen a newspaper in, I don't know, 5 years. Right? How about door hangers? How many of you are happy when you go out there and there's a hanging piece on your door? How many of you do anything with that? Is that how you want to find a gynecologist? "Look, honey, I found this hanging on the door, and there's a free first visit. Dr. Rob Jackson at your cervix, right? I'm right here." Is that how you want to get an important doctor in your family's life? Some of you are just starting to get that. Did he say cervix? Can you say that on the stage? Maybe that's why Parker never let me on the big stage before. I don't know. I just say things. I grew up on a farm. Things happen out there. The crooked pins, guess what? Crooked pins are cute. They're still cute. But I haven't gotten a patient from a crooked pin in, I don't know, 20 years. And the refrigerator magnets, if they're stainless steel, they don't even stick to them. That's the cool thing now. They're stainless. You have to come around to the side of the fridge to get a magnet to stick to it now. And instead, they have all their kids' stuff on there, somehow taped to it and everything else. So your magnet's not working the way it used to. And then, of course, there's the Valpak coupons. You're right in there with the specialty people who sell tires and put new screen doors on your house. And I don't know, we're associating ourselves with people that other people aren't sure they trust. Think about that. As you're going through the package, are those people that you really trust? So is that where you want to put your ad? It's not that it might not work for some people, but again, business cards and stationery. You know, it used to be that that was a given. You got to do stationery. You have to have that stuff. That's a given. People expect you to have that. So that's not revolutionary. But I showed some of the students my business card today, and I showed them it was a little bit unique and it was a little bit different. Let me see if I can get one out of my pocket here. I think I have one in here. I tried to share one. There we go. This is what happens when you're doing it. Now, this is my business card. Doesn't that look like a normal size? Guess what? Mine opens up, and then it has stuff on the back. Because if you leave the back of yours blank, you're wasting 7 square inches of paper you could be telling people about stuff. I've got a map on here. I've got a list of everything I do. I've got all my services. I've got everything I've got provided. I've got hours. I've got web link. I've even got my video link on there to something I'm going to show you in a little bit. So if you're going to do something with your business cards, how about you make them a little bit unique and a little bit different? One of the best business cards I ever got from a chiropractor was a little bitty tiny one. It was only about this big. And I looked at it, and I had to look really close, and it said, "The size of this business card is due to your lack of referrals." And then it had his name and information on the back. And you know what? It was the funniest business card I ever saw. I thought, now that is good. It's not your first business card you give out. You should have a business card for every day of the week. Have I given you my card before? Yeah, well, that was my Monday card. Here's my Tuesday card. You need one of these. Why not have 6 or 7 different kinds of business cards? And you think they're supposed to stay there in the little box and sit there so you always have them. No, they're not. They're supposed to be given out. You're supposed to have to reprint them over and over again. And you never, ever, ever only give one business card away. You know why? Because you give three. Because when you give three, you say, here's a business card for you and a couple others for other people you might know who also need me at my office. Why wouldn't you tell people right up front that I'm expecting you to share what I have to offer with other people? Why wouldn't you do that? Because you want to keep more business cards in your pocket? That's not building your business. And then we have those crusty old anatomical charts in our office that are now 45 years old, and they're looking a little bit like they have pee stains on them or something like that, but you're just so affluent, you can't afford the $20 for a new chart. They're $19.95, almost anywhere that you look. Parker Shares got them. They're all over the world. Get some new charts, okay? Don't be afraid to upgrade your look. So these old ideas, we're going to get rid of those. We're going to think in terms of looking at them differently and at them new. And here's some new ideas instead. Maybe these things will work a little bit better for you. How about making sure you have a website? Now, let me suggest something. Don't create your own website. You are not a skilled tech person. I know this is news to many of you, but because you're not busy and you're sitting there for 2 hours thinking, I don't have anything else to do, so I should create my own website, that's like asking somebody who's never driven a car to get behind the wheel of the car and say, this doesn't look all that hard, I should be able to figure that out. Right? And we hear about teenagers who get in the car when their parents aren't looking and they drive away and crash into somebody. There are professional people who build websites for a living and they're not very much money. Use a professional to do it, because then you're going to be put on the right search engines and you're going to be found in the right places, and it's going to drive people to your business. You can give them new content as you need to, but trust me, you're not the tech-savvy person you think you are. Social media, we're all going to have to do it. Rick Rinn, bless his heart, told me that he took a video of me talking this morning and he posted it on Facebook. Now, could I do that to myself? No, I wasn't doing a selfie the whole time saying, look, I'm going to put it on Facebook later. No, but he posted it on social media. My phone already blew up with people going, wow, that's the first time I've seen something posted on you on Facebook for like 20 years. Because I don't do that a lot. I just go in there and check on my kids. But the nice thing is he used social media to help me that way. Email. That's a way to market. What are you doing? All right, digital technology. When I talk digital, guess what? We're in the digital world. It's time for you to upgrade. How many of you are still using a flip phone? Just throw it in the trash on the way out right now. I'm just telling you right now. It's time to get, my front desk calls them a dumbass phone, but they're really supposed to be a smartphone because she can't figure out how to use it, so, you know, but it's how it works. Digital signage. You know what I did? My office has been in the same location for 46 years. That sign that was out there on the street had lights shining on it. It was a great sign. It was painted well, had my name, my hours, but you know what? It became invisible because it had been there for 46 years. People were so used to driving by it, it became invisible. It's a lot like your posters in your office. If you don't change those posters around once a month, people stop seeing them because they've been there and they just ignore them. Let me give you a better example. Men, how many of you have a wedding ring on right now? Raise your hand. How many of you can't feel that ring? Most of you can't. After 10 minutes, you lose the sensation. Men forget about it in about 30 seconds, ladies. In case you haven't noticed, they have a wedding ring on, but they sometimes look at other things as if it's not on. Right? You desensitize to it. Ladies, you have a necklace around your neck. You don't feel that anymore. Now that I mentioned it, you're like, oh, wait a minute, now I do. But we get desensitized. Our patients are just like us. They get desensitized too. They lose that sign. They lose that poster. They lose that idea because they're no longer sensitized to it. So you know what I did? I tore out that sign and I put a digital sign out there that changes. It has the hours, it has the temperature, and it has, I have a thing where I show somebody on their hands and knees and it says, crawl-ins welcome. You can't believe every single month I get two or three new patients from people who say, I saw that crawl-ins thing, that's what's going on with my back. Now, you know, I don't like to treat pain so much as I like to treat just subluxations and fix them, but people come to me because they're in pain. So I need to reach them where they are so that I can educate them about what I really have to offer with chiropractic. So I have to start where they are sometimes. So I put a digital sign out there, and now I even get people who stop by and tell me, you know, your time's off on your sign out there. And I'm like, are you a patient here? No, it just makes me mad when I drive by and I see your time is off. So I thought I'd better let you know. I'm like, well, you're here, maybe we should get your spine checked. But they care about it. They see my sign now every day. Well, of course, you've got your EHR documentation. You've got plenty of people out there selling EHR stuff. If you're not doing electronic notes, perk it up. It's time to change, right? Because if you do any Medicare billing, it's the law now. You got to do it. There's search engines. There's smartphones. We talked about those already. There's digital posters. How many of you have ever seen a flat screen TV? Anybody? Do they have them down here in Dallas? The flat screen things, right? Yeah. Guess what? You can put one of those on the wall in your office. You can put digital posters on there. And you can have 25 or 30 different versions that every minute and a half they change. Now, if you bought 25 or 30 posters, it would cost you thousands of dollars. But you can get digital posters for not very much money. And you get all the power, all the benefit, and the change which causes people to look. What happens to you if you walk in a room and a TV's on? Even if it's some pathetic soap opera, you'll actually watch it. Because it's TV, just for something to do, right? Well, what if it's got chiropractic stuff changing on it right there? What a concept, what an idea. And it gives you the ability to write off a TV and put it at your office. Kind of fun. Canvas wrapped ideas, 3D instead of 2D. These are some ideas that can work. Now, let's dive into this a little bit further, all right? What we want to do is we want to take, that's the first lie, is use my stuff. Well, we're all clear that stuff doesn't work. Number two, follow these magical scripts and your staff will be able to close the most difficult cases for long-term care. Just memorize this script. Anytime you memorize a script, you sound like one of those Hollywood movies where a guy's talking into his buddy's ear and he's trying to help him get a date with a girl that he sees because he doesn't know how to talk to her himself. Does that ever work out good in the movies? And it doesn't work out good in real life either. It's not that there aren't scripts that are helpful and that really can benefit us, because we learn things, but if you don't personalize that stuff, it sounds very canned when you make that presentation. How many of you have ever been to a resort where they say, hey, if you just come listen to our two-hour presentation about buying the timeshare thing here, we'll give you something free before you leave. Anybody ever gone to a timeshare thing? Was it a little canned or what? Now, we sit there and we just keep practicing. Say no at the end. Say no at the end. Just say no at the end and we'll be good, right? But you're planning on saying no. So what do you think people are saying when you're reciting a script to them? And if you just join today for only $29.99 for the whole year, you can have unlimited care in our office and you'll just feel really terrific. Ooh, I can hardly wait to sign up. How about a little bit of passion in when your conversation is? And you can't have passion with a script. All right? So that's a thing that's not working. Now, how do people really learn? I talked about this a little bit this morning. People learn really in a couple of ways. Number one is impact. You heard a testimonial, you heard a story, and if that didn't impact you a little bit, then you better check and make sure your ticker's still working. Because it's probably not if that story didn't have an impact on you. Because I was standing in the back and it made me go like this a little bit. My kids hate to take me to a Disney movie because I cry in Disney movies. I'm just one of those guys. Every time something bad happens to one of the heroines or whatever, and I just feel really bad. And my daughters are like, Dad, you know? I had to take my girls to all of the vampire movies at midnight when they came out. What were those things where, you know, the difference between the white one and the Indian guy, and it was crazy. I'm sitting there in a whole theater full of women and me. I'm like, God, if I wasn't married, this would be good odds in here. I'm telling you what. And then when that guy takes his shirt off and shows those washboard abs, and all the women sucked all the oxygen right out of there because they all went, and I couldn't catch my breath for a minute. I was looking for air. But that was an impactful moment in that movie. I'm going to tell you what. It changed everybody's temperature about 2 degrees. So impact is important. Then there's repetition. You got to say it over and over and over. How many of you have teenagers? You know what they look like? Have you ever seen one? All right, I have 11 kids. So I know somebody coughed in the back. I should have coughed once or twice and maybe that would have helped. But I've had teenagers in my life, okay? And if I don't repeat things sometimes multiple times, now you know what I have to do? I have to text them and make sure that they get it a couple times. And if I send a text 3 or 4 times, then I've repeated it enough that you're going to be home by midnight. That's the deal. And until they respond, I just keep sending it again and again. Repetition is a powerful tool, right? So, number one with impact, how do you introduce chiropractic to people? What are you doing that creates any kind of an emotional appeal or impact? What are you doing? Do you walk up and say, well, I'm a chiropractor and you know, I'd like to get my hands all over your body and see if I can make you feel better. Now, I've got these two little hands hiding under my microphone right here, and invariably, I wear these two hands anytime I travel and anytime I speak, and people, you know who can't not say something to me about those? Women. Now, I don't know about you, but women have been my favorite subject for the last 45 years of my life. And the more I study them, the more I understand, I just don't know a thing about them. I can't figure it out. But they can't help but notice that, and they go, oh, those are cute. What's that for? And I'm like, well, I'm a chiropractor. I put my hands all over you, and I make you feel better. And they always laugh, but then they say, really? And I'm like, yeah, actually, I have a couple of daughters that are away at school right now playing volleyball, and they have to use their hands all the time, and so it makes me think about them because they're competitive. And one of them plays for Bradley University up in Illinois, and she's playing tonight, and I wished I was there watching, but you know what? she's in college and that's what she's doing, having fun. So, but I have some impact. I'm always trying to find a way to get people to feel like, wow, that's interesting. So can your staff right now write down the five components of the vertebral subluxation complex? Can you? If your staff can't repeat that, guess what? Your staff are real people. Sometimes I give the report of findings of my life. I'm in there and I'm talking and I'm showing tools and I'm whistling Dixie and I'm going all the way through, and I walk out of there and I'm like, man, I nailed it. And they walk out to my front desk and they go, how much longer do I have to keep coming? Does that nerve really go down my leg, or was he just pulling my chain? And if my staff can't repeat what's really going on, if they don't understand how the vertebral subluxation complex works, because my staff is a real person, she's much more believable, or he's much more believable than I ever am, because they don't trust me already because I'm a chiropractor. That's how they explain it to their friends. Oh, I saw my chiropractor today. I go to choir practice on Wednesday night. See the chiropractor, right? So if your staff doesn't know the five components, you better make sure you educate them. Get it done. And you better be able to talk about them too, because however you practice, you affect one or two or more of all five component parts. Science now has even broken it down a little bit deeper into eight parts, and they really like to break the chemistry down and some other things like that because of nutrition and medications and things that are available. But guess what? It's happening. You got bones, you got nerves, you got muscles, you got associated soft tissues, which includes the blood supply and the lymph supply and discs, ligaments and tendons, and then you've got the disease or degenerative process. You've got these five main parts, and somehow we all take care of them. Does your staff get regular care? Students, are you getting regular care? If you're getting adjusted once a month and you're expecting your patients to come once a week, doesn't that feel a little hypocritical? Now, maybe you only need it once a month. But guess what? If you sit on your bum every day for 8 to 10 hours and then you go home and study and your neck's going forward like this, there is no way that you only need to be adjusted once a month. No physical way. The stress of being a chiropractic student in today's environment, with the amount of money it's costing you, the amount of time you got to go, and the work that you do when you get there, every one of you needs to get checked more regular. And if you're not looking at your patients, realizing they're under stress and things are different for them and they need to get care too, if you're expecting them to only come once a month, you're going to starve to death. They need what they need. Individually, you need to make sure that you're individually telling them what that looks like and why. But if your staff's not getting care and you're trying to sell this idea of regular care to your patients, it's never going to close at the front desk. Does your staff refer new people to you? Do you get new referrals from your staff? Because guess what? They meet people you never, ever meet. They know people you don't know. And don't those people have a spine too? I think they do. I'm not blaming the staff or anything. I'm just asking your question, because these are people that you spend 8 to 10 hours a day with every single day. And if you're not communicating effectively to them, then I'm worried about what you're not communicating to your patients as well. Somehow the tire needs to meet the road here. And then what information do you know that your staff hasn't learned? I asked a bunch of people this today. I said, when was your last adjustment? When was your last adjustment? This morning. Who told you that you had to get adjusted? You. So why are you so special that you know that nobody else could know that about themselves? You're not. You're a great guy, but you're not that special. You just learned about your body, and you learned, you know what? I need to get checked. I got something going on. And you know what's really scary about chiropractors is we call it wellness care, but we only see each other when we have something that's not well. And we say, could you check me? Because this is a little stuck right here. That's not wellness care. That's symptom care. But we do get adjusted more regular than our patients. So guess what? We call it wellness, but the word wellness has been messed up. It's proactive care is really what it is, because we're being proactive. Before this gets ugly, before this becomes more symptomatic, before it becomes problematic and it affects my physiology, I want to get checked right now and have a healthy nervous system. That's what I want. I want to keep it going. So, with that in mind, let's keep moving down the line here. All right. Number three, the same report of findings works for everybody. If you believe that, I've got a bridge I want to sell you and it's down in the desert in Arizona, right? It doesn't work that way. If your report of findings is a canned presentation, stop wasting your time. You know what this is? It's a remote control. How many of your patients do you think have a remote control at home? The minute you start presenting a canned report of findings, 5 minutes in, they point it at you in their mind and they shut you off right there and their brain stops working. And they start going la, 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 like that. So what we need to do is we need to customize our report and we need to make it individual for each person. So with that in mind, you ever heard Charlie Brown before? His teachers, when the teacher talks? That's exactly what it looks like. The remote control's going, we need to make a change. So what kind of changes can we introduce here? How do we fix this, and how do we get 10 to 15 new patients over the next 30 to 60 days? What if I could actually do that for you? It can, we can do that, but you have to be willing to change a little bit. You have to be willing to do something. You have to be just a little bit more proactive. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna throw an idea out there. I'm gonna share something with you, and we're gonna take just a moment and we're gonna look at it. And so, how many of you know what this is? This is the new iPhone 6S Plus or whatever it is. It's a phone, right? But it's a phablet. That's what my kids call it. It's a phablet because it's so dang big you can hardly get your hands around it. So it's a cross between a tablet and a phone, but it actually works. Now, let me see here. All right. So, do you have a smartphone? What's your phone number? Hang on 1 second here. 314-210, okay? 6556. How long did that take me? About 15 seconds? I just did something. I just shared my clinic video with him, and I sent it to his smartphone before he ever comes in as a new patient. It's customized just for me, just my clinic, nobody else. The benefit is he's gonna get it on his tablet, on his computer, or on his smartphone, however he wants to read it. And what do you think he's gonna do when he gets it? Because how many of you don't like getting a video from one of your friends of that stupid cat crawling up the tree or whatever else is going on, right? But what happens when you look at a video? You look at it, first of all, and then what do you do with it? You share it with a bunch of your friends, don't you? So here's my deal. I've only got so much time to do marketing because I want to spend time seeing patients. That's my goal. So if somebody calls to schedule a new patient visit with me, I send my video out. My front desk people do. They say, how would you like to receive it, email or text? Because we're going to get their email and or we're going to get their text, their cell phone number either way, because we want that information, right? And we're going to send that out before they ever come in, and they're going to get to watch my new patient video customized for me before they ever walk in the door, which is going to save them time on their first visit, and it's going to answer questions that are going around in the back of their head creating static noise that prevents them from taking advantage of chiropractic, and it's going to turn them into a referral tool where they do all the work for me, and I can stay at work and get paid for doing what I do best. So that idea in mind, what we really want to do is we want to turn this into a money-making idea. So how do we do that? Let's take a look at this first one. First of all, figure out what personality you have and choose the tools that match your particular approach. Are you an analytical? Are you an amiable? Are you a driver? Are you expressive? What are you? Every one of my kids is different. My oldest daughter, 35, she's a nurse. Man, she is a type A driver. And I don't know where she gets that from because I am the calmest, nicest person you would ever want to meet. Right? Yeah. No, she's me on steroids, and that's what's scary. She is a driver, man. And she has 4 kids, but they are marshaled, and you would think she was in the military because those kids stand at attention and yes, ma'am, and no, ma'am, and whatever it is. And it's grandpa, sir, when they come over. The greatest grandkids in the world, but guess what? She has them in power. Now, the middle kids, their kids are kind of, we don't care if they touch that, they can go all over the place because they're more amiable. They just want to get along and have a great time, right? So everybody's unique and everybody's different. Then my youngest son, he is an expressive. He just blows up all the time. The other night I got a message from his school that said, you're missing two reports, so your grades just dropped from an A down to a C+. And so I came home and I said, guess what? I see a little lack of motivation on your part to finish your homework, and so I'm highly motivated at this point to help you. So with my motivation being high and yours being low, I'm gonna change your life just a little bit, and you're not gonna play any games on your computer until these reports get done. Oh my God, you would have thought I killed him and killed his favorite dog, favorite cat, and took away his whole life. He goes, you just took away my whole life. And I'm like, no, I took one thing. Your whole life is fine. I took one thing, but the expressiveness of his whole thing, he had to get all this out, right? So we have to talk to people the way they are. So figure out who they are and plan accordingly, number one. Number two, use technology to communicate for you. It took me 15 seconds to use technology to reach a new patient. I'm going to show you what I sent him.
Welcome to our office. This short presentation can help you understand chiropractic and what to expect
from
your first visit
here with
us.
And my name right there.
Chiropractic is based on the scientific fact that your nervous system controls the function of virtually every cell, tissue, organ, and system of your entire body. Bending, turning, and lifting depend on the proper function of your nervous system, as does breathing, digestion, or fighting off an infection. Your body is controlled by your brain, which is a delicate computer-like organ. The brain is protected by the skull and communicates with the tissues and organs of the body through the spinal cord, which is housed in the moving bones of the spinal column. Pairs of nerve roots branch off the spinal cord from between each spinal joint to service the entire body. A feedback loop, back and forth from the brain, monitors the function of everything that is going on. Spinal bones in your neck and back can lose their normal motion or position, adversely affecting the nervous system due to repetitive...
So, I'm not going to show you the whole video. I'm just going to tease you with it a little bit. The bottom line is this. It's 3D. It's in high def. And it's fun. And in 4.5 minutes, it's going to answer everything that people are going to want to know or think about when they're going. And at the beginning and at the end, it's customized just for me. And so I'm going to take you through a couple of steps if you want to do that. Now, many of you already have a video tool. You can do the very same thing with your own video tool. If you like your tool, then put it to work. If you like my tool, you can talk to me about that later. That's not the whole idea of doing this. What I'm interested in is the impact. Because if I can create impact for people before they ever come in, their expectations for what they might get from me when they get there goes up exponentially. So I want to create realistic expectations that my office stands notches above anything else they have ever experienced in chiropractic or medicine, period. Because they're not getting this stuff. You know what I hear every day when they come in? I've never gotten anything like that from my medical provider or anybody else. That was amazing for you to send that to me before I came in. All right? So let's talk about some ideas. What could we do to this? And we already talked about how we're going to send it out. I'm going to give you 10 quick ideas. Number one, here's 10 marketing strategies. Number one, send it out to new patients when they schedule on their mobile phone, tablet, or computer so they can view it and share it with others. We talked about that already. That's a given. Take pictures with your phone if you wanted this, because these are ideas that you're going to get for free right here. Add it to your website, Facebook page, LinkedIn, and Twitter account, or to Pinterest, anything else that you do. Add it to every social media thing that you do with your profile and or your picture. Add it right there, because if people look you up, if they want to see something, why wouldn't they find your video there? Number three, include the link as a printed part on your business card and or on your checks and or on personal checks under your name and address. Why wouldn't you want that with anybody who does business with you, that gets a check from you? Because they're going to look at that, and what do people do? They're like cats. They're curious. You put something different on the counter, and your cat sees it, what are they going to do? How many people have a cat? Anybody? Yes. The rest of you aren't admitting it, are you? How many of you have dogs? Okay, right? Dogs are different than cats. Dogs have owners. Cats have staff. Right? That's kind of how it works. And if you have a cat, you know exactly what I'm talking about. If I set something a little different up on the counter and my cat sees that, I have a Maine Coon. I have a big cat because I live on the side of the mountain. And that cat has to defend itself against mountain lions and bobcats and foxes and everything else. And so she doesn't take crap from anybody. My next door neighbor has 3 Malamutes. She walks right over, jumps through their yard, walks right between them, and goes right through their dog door and goes in there looking for something to eat on their counter. And they have these 3 big 150-pound dogs, and they know better than to mess with her. And she just looks at him and goes, hmm. So, but cats do whatever they want, but they're curious, right? So if you add that onto your page, people are going to go, what's that? And they're going to type it in, or they're going to take a picture, and they're going to go there. All right, here's a couple more. Use it when you do health fairs and send it to potential patients right while they're standing there at your booth. It's as simple as what I just did with him. Use it at speaking engagements, showing it there either on a projector, laptop, or on a tablet to include the link so that they can share it with others when they leave. If you like to speak to the Rotary, to the Elks Club, to the Kiwanis, any of those, Chamber of Commerce, guess what? Everybody loves a short 4.5 minute video. Everybody loves it because it means you shut up for a minute, right? Send the link to all your existing patients. Now, if you've been in business for more than a year, send it to all your existing patients and tell them this is for them to share with those they've been trying to get to come in but have been unable to convince them because they don't know the right words or what they need to do to get them to come in. Because every one of your existing patients has at least one or two people. Right now, every one of them knows one or two people who need you, and maybe they're not sure on how to get them to come in. So they don't say anything. Or add the link to your signature whenever you sign an email or include it on your contact information. Anytime I send anything to anybody, the link is going to be there. Include the link in your church or temple directory, your homeowners association directory, and any other membership or club directories that you belong to. Why wouldn't you put it out there for everybody? Because guess what? You're in the spine checking business, and pretty much everybody you're going to meet anywhere has a spine. Have it saved on your smartphone with a coupon or a discount offer that's legal to use in your state that you can share with anyone at a moment's notice when the topic of health, chiropractic, or whatever it is that you do for a living comes up. And send it to inactive patients with a coupon offer that's legal to use in your state to get them back in for care. Guess what? That one thing in my office, when I started doing that, blew the doors off my office because I've been in business for 33 years. And so I just started picking segments, and at first I made the mistake of sending it to 100 people at a time. Oh my God. We had 28 people who came back in for reactivation the first time we did that, and I almost couldn't fit them all in. And so now we do it to 30 people at a time because of that 30% ratio that we're getting to reactivate with the coupon that we added to it, and it just builds our business every single week. So if you're worried about the holidays are always slow, I don't know how I'm going to get people to come back in, and you've been in business for 2 years, 3 years, 5 years, 10 years, 20 years, this is a way to make the next 2 months so dramatically different that you won't know what to do with the numbers. So our real goal here is for you to find a way to make something. And it might mean you have to do a little work. You have to take your video, you have to add something to it, you have to get somebody who's technically savvy to be able to do it, or you can talk to somebody else who knows how to do that. We know how to do it. There's lots of other people that know how to do it. The idea is just do it. Just do one thing differently and make a dramatic change in how you present yourself to people, different than what you were doing before you came down here. Some of you are struggling right now. Some of you are just like the people that were up here talking, and in your situation, you're like, I don't have a lot of food at home. I don't have a lot of money, but I spent my last dollar to come to Parker so I could get down here and get this thing done. And what you're looking for is that little notch. What you're hoping is that one of the vendors out there has a little switch and you can just buy it and attach it to the wall. And when you go back on Monday, you throw the switch and new patients just start walking in the door like this. But guess what happened? That switch isn't for sale anymore. That worked back in the 70s, but it doesn't work now. But there are ideas, there are people out there, there are ways that you can do that, and you can make some dramatic changes if you're willing to change. So, with that in mind, we got to think about this. Get ready, mentally, get ready for 10 to 50 new or reactivated patients over the next 30 to 60 days. I didn't know what to expect. I thought, well, what if 10% comes? Instead, I've gotten 30% to reactivate. So I'll be doing that for a long time. Number two, make sure that you have the materials you need to follow through, and make sure that you and your staff can repeat the message. If you've got a message, make sure your staff knows what that message is. Have tools with great pictures that help and tell the story and that patients can then take home with them. Did you see the new stuff that Parker has out there? You know, there's lots of good stuff that you can put to work if you're going to be willing to do it. And then have tools at your front desk that can increase your bottom line. Make your front desk more valuable. Make sure their computer is working, that it's state of the art, and that it gives them the ability to do everything that you want them to be able to do. It's a $1,000 investment anymore to get a brand new computer for your front desk. but it can literally make them so much more efficient because it works and functions the way you need it to do it. All right? So we got repetition because we're going to follow through. We had impact and we had repetition. Bottom line, be bad to the bone this week. Have some fun, get out there, and do one thing different. All right? Thanks for your time today.